Am I going the wrong way?
No, you're not. There's no right or wrong way. Just see if you know. Somebody he could ask, but he seemed to sit right in. He's right in the group of other meow guys.
Perfect. All fine. I like that. Windows are down, not up. So I got black flag last time for having my windows up, and they were down, but I nevertheless was.
But you took it with good humor, right?
I did.
A compliment to how well you keep your car clean.
I get, but it did. I felt like I had been busted for drug possession or whatever else, something I hadn't done. You know, I just...
Okay, so, just as a recap of the things we talked about, the most important thing is to look as far ahead as possible all the time. Looking around the corners, even if you can't see exactly where you're going, just keeping your vision up and in front of the car as far as possible.
For flaggers, look for far ahead.
You'll find that if you have your eyes up, you will see the flags. It's real distinctive when someone's waving a yellow thing over in the corner of your field of vision. You recognize that. So just, we're going to keep your eyes up. Second, to be as smooth as possible with all the controls. As I remember the last time we worked, we were focusing a bit on your braking, and that may change today because of the new equipment. So, we'll have to see how the car goes, you'll have to see how the car feels. You modulate your pressure on the brake pedal. Some people say treat the brake pedal like an eggshell, you don't want to squeeze it too hard. I have a hard time with that one myself, but I do like the idea of a squeeze and release instead of a jump on hard.
Okay.
And you'll find even with firm pads, just that squeezing process, the pad will do the work for you. It's gonna engage. You will know. So you don't have to jump on the brake pedal to get it to work. Were super hard, all-in race car pads, hard as possible. Yeah, you might have a great part.
Okay.
Is all set?
All set.
All right.
Thank you. So, eyes up.
Thank you. Thank you.
Tremendously in the session to remember to be smooth with all the controls, smoother with the brakes particularly, but dial the wheel in for a turn, dial it out. Treat it right, be super sensitive, be a smart. You can get away with the discipline at these speeds. You can't when you start going fast, because the car will get upset if you'll lose grip of the corner or one angle.
Also, I will
tell you. Let's do this. Don't park there. Let's go drive one lap around the parking lot. So for that,
streets, I don't ever brake like that. I did notice that on the foot, since I got these new pads this last 2 weeks, that when I hit the brakes coming off the freeway, I get some wheel vibration that I didn't think was grabbing so much harder than they ever used to. Resurface them?
Oh, they did.
They did resurface them and put
okay.
it back on. So,
yeah, so they turned them. In other words,
they turned them.
Yeah. They
is this your vehicle?
No, that's all right. Go back to your parking spot. So anyway, I would go out again.
Testosterone, just pick up, kick in.
And if you can resist that, and be mindful of the fact that you need to have everything on, including your brakes, then you may have less of that. And if you get to the end of the day, and you're driving home, and you say, oh my God, I got this terrible vibration all the time, then you may have time to do this. But otherwise, I think it's going to work out for you.
Okay, beautiful. I'm not really this, but...
running super hard pads is it's buyer's choice, right? I myself don't do that on the street. There's Hawk makes a pad called the HPS, which is a it's kind of a grade above a street pad and a grade below a full track pad. And that's what I used to run. I ran this for all my track days and ran them on the street, and they were great. But I don't know whether you're making for this car or maybe something else you like that.
One, by the way, I got something else different because Hawks, I mean, highly recommended, but they said they were more abusive to the rotor, or harder on the rotor. So they said, well, if you do Carbotech, which I have all words I've never heard before, you know, you'll live longer, and they have a 1,350-degree heat capacity versus the 800 I was running.
Right.
And so it's an upgrade. Whether they're as good as Hawks, I'm not sure. But
it's interesting you focus right on that one element because that's exactly the phenomenon I'm talking about. Now you've got a brake pad that can operate and will operate effectively at a much higher heat range. But where's that heat going?
Yes, indeed. Absolutely it is. I upgraded my brake fluid so it wouldn't boil as fast, and I put in cooling ducts additionally. So I'm hoping I have 1,450 degrees of versus, you know, extra, you know, so I'm going to keep hoping.
All right, so remember, when you thought the most time, eyes up, and you're picking up your reference points, you're looking through the corners before you turn the steering wheel on, move your eyes before you move your hands, and then as you get comfortable going around the track, which I think will come back, you know, it's going to be very quick, then you can start paying attention to what am I actually doing with the car. Am I upsetting the car by stabbing the brake pedal, or am I slowing it down and letting it rebalance itself before I turn in? That's where you want to be. You want the car to be balanced at the point when you turn the steering wheel over turn.
On turn two, you're coming straight down. I'm downshifting. How? But I'm not stabbing. I'm really on the brakes, correct? I mean, I'm just making sure I'm on them, and I'm rolling, easing off them at the end of the turn, and make just turning one smooth single apex turn.
And the most, again, the most important element of that whole turn is to pick up that single apex while you're in the brake position. You're going to be on the brakes. But if you have to make a brake, I'm going way faster, I better brake, or I'm a little bit too wide, or I'm in too close, maybe because then I can't really turn all the way into the second apex. I'll make a little adjustment. If you're not looking, vision thing is rule number one. And then the smoothness. Your sense of where to put the car is good. The only thing that, as a third step only, once you get comfortable with where you're looking at, how you're using the controls, try to either use the car feel like it's tipped over and kind of bound up a little bit too much after this corner. Can I open the wheel a little more? Can I let the car go all the way to the outside?
I was on the steering wheel too long on some of those turns because it's like, well, now you're going to nail the apex, but you didn't need to. You could have gone a little further. You're heading that way anyway. Why did you keep turning for the apex when you've already missed it? So I noticed that I...
Well, you know, one time you just missed both apexes because I was talking to you and you weren't focused, and that's perfectly understandable. But on the other hand, when you came into the number two, the braking zone for number two, when you looked and said, oh, there's my target, over there, okay. As soon as you see it, your brain can help you make whatever adjustments you need to make. You absolutely nailed it a couple of times. Those are the times when you got to the apex, you were almost parallel to the apex berm. The car was pointed down the track, not off, not inside, but down the track. The car was settled.
Yes, yes, thank you. You are a true, you're a treasure, and thank you very much for...
No, I enjoy doing this.
You must, but thank you very much. It shows that you do.
Yeah, well, have fun today, no matter what else happens.
I most certainly should. Thank you. I'm gonna, and you have no idea. I'm glad you were first, because now I'm gonna practice that turn all day as a single apex, so to speak.
Yep.